waters of baptism, Steve died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. I'd like to welcome you all for this funeral mass for Steve, and it's a time where we pray for him and also with him. At the altar, we join with all the folks who are in Christ, and that's a beautiful expression. Let us begin by an opening prayer. O God, in whose presence the dead are alive, and in whom your saints rejoice full happiness, grant our supplication that your servant Steve, for whom the fleeting light of this world shines no more, may enjoy the comfort of your light for all eternity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated for the word.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are at peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet in their hope full of immortality, chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
There is nothing I shall want.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you aware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin, for a dead person has been absolved from sin. If, then, we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven, and not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated. On behalf of St. Alois Church, I would like to extend our condolences, especially to the family, but also to all you friends here. During this time of loss, there's times where you're gonna have, you know, it's okay to cry, it's okay. Even I think back just a couple, well, maybe 3 years or so for my own mom, that, you know, there's times when you just say, oh, I wish I could just, but that's the way it is. And so during this time, I hope that you sense this comfort of the Holy Spirit. This gospel that we have this morning is actually part of a rather lengthy talk that Jesus gives. It's called the Bread of Life one, and it happens on the occasion where Jesus is, frankly, fairly early on his ministry, and he goes up a mountain and performs a huge miracle where all kinds of people were fed. And it was up a mountain in a wilderness, and he feeds them. And people put two and two together, and they said, oh, maybe Jesus might be the one they prophesied in the book of Deuteronomy, one like unto Moses would come. And they wanted immediately to make him king, but he kind of slipped away from them. And then he later on came to Capernaum and continued with this discourse because they wanted, well, they wanted free food, fast food, and just get it very quickly. And he had to explain a little bit more about his mission and why he was there. Now, it's all about this bread of life, that Jesus is the bread that comes down, the manna that comes down from heaven. But in the middle of all this teaching is this kind of golden nugget of truth that is kind of like hidden if you're going through that chapter. You're just kind of going along and you're staying with it. But in between is this beautiful expression that is given here. And what we get out of here is that Jesus is assuring the folks, I and the Father are one. What the Father wants, I want. I want to do whatever he wants. And the second thing that you get out of this is the importance. I'm not going to lose a single person or a single thing for this. I want it all to be done in such a way that it is completely done properly. So that's the background to this wonderful statement that's given here. Now, I like to read it again, but from a different translation. Well, not even a translation. It's called a paraphrase. And Eugene Peterson has this one. And to kind of get the feel or the of what he's trying to say, the great promise that's been given here. And this is what is written here. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. The person who aligns with me hungers no more and thirsts no more, ever. I have told you this explicitly because even though you have seen me in action, you don't really believe me. Every person the Father gives me eventually comes running to me. And once that person is with me, I hold on and don't let go. I came down from heaven not to follow my own whim, but to accomplish the will of the one who sent me. This, in a nutshell, is that will, that everything handed over to me by my Father be completed, not a single detail missed. And at the wrap-up of time, I have everything and everyone put together, upright and whole. This is what my Father wants, that anyone who sees the Son and trusts who he is and what he does, and then aligns with him, will enter real life. Eternal life. My part is to put them on their feet alive and whole at the completion of time. It's a beautiful promise. Something that Jesus says, I'm going to do for you. This is what I want you to do. Now, for those of us who have put faith in Christ and have done that, we already have kind of the first fruits of the Holy Spirit kind of stirring within our soul, and we have that. But deep down we know, I can't make myself go into the presence of God Almighty just totally on my own. I need help. And that help is the Lord saying, Jesus saying, you put your hands in my hands, I will get you there. You will get there safe and sound. That's my job. And I want that to be done well. I remember sitting and just behind you is that's where Steve was sitting. He made his way here to this church. He hadn't been here for a long time. I don't remember ever really meeting him. I'd only been here for 2 years. So he made it here. He couldn't get up, he couldn't stand, but he sat through the whole Mass, and he just sat through the whole thing, and I think someone motioned, maybe Martha, you were there, to come over and give communion to him. And then afterwards, I then, kind of was introduced to him and what he was desiring, and he's saying, you know, I want to prepare myself for death and have everything. So we did an anointing right there and then. It was there. And then he had some more things that he wanted to discuss. But what struck me is that he wanted everything to be done just right, so that when time comes, it's taken care of properly. Now, I don't think any of us had in our wildest imaginations a big forest fire, or that COVID and all that has, and that took over and all this, and in the middle of that, he ends up in the hospital. And so I gave him a call, and we started talking. And it wasn't very long, and just talking to him, he says, "You probably can't come in here, can you?" I said, "No, I can't." He said, "That's okay. It's okay." And we had a wonderful conversation from that point. Just a sense of peace. Everything had been taken care of, what he had to do. He had to depend on the Lord. He had to put his hands in the Lord and say, "This part of the chapter, I got to put it in your hands, Lord." It's a beautiful picture of faith. I can't do it all on my own. I got to put it in the hands of the Lord Jesus, and he will bring me home. Let's continue to pray for him and for each other as we are on our journey of life. We too grow in that beautiful relationship with our God.
Let us stand to pray. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Steve received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Steve seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and distill their darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Steve. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of his son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands,
May the offering of this sacrifice be pleasing to you, Lord, so that the soul of your servant Steve, finding through your mercy the pardon he sought for his sins, may exalt forever with your saints and praise your glory for all eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You may be seated for me. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope,
Alexander, our bishop, Peter, auxiliary bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Steve, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
thank you. we receive these heavenly gifts, we give thanks, O Lord. Humbly pray that the soul of your servant Steve, free through your son's passion from the bonds of sin, may come happily into your presence through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated for some words of remembrance.
Steve collected people like some people collect coins, and there was absolutely no way that if he met you as a stranger, you would not become his friend, because that's just who he was. And there are so many stories in this church. Allegra, your story is an amazing one, but we have time for two. Two letters came to Martha, and she asked me to read them. One of them I couldn't print out, I apologize, so I'm going to do the unforgivable and read this from my phone. But it was from his brother, Fred, and his sister. Steve was the oldest of the three of them, and their memories are quite amazing. Some of you know him from all the time he was here in Estacada, but there's so much more to Steve's life. So I'll try to get through this and not cry again. Today we want to remember our brother Stephen and how special he was to us. Having him in our lives made a difference. He was always someone to laugh with, have fun times with, and to learn and enrich our lives with. Steve started on the road to success at an early age. He was a gifted athlete, excelling in baseball and wrestling. He achieved the highest rank available in Boy Scouts, a proud Eagle Scout. He was a firefighter in his hometown in New Jersey and also in Gresham, Oregon. All of this required hard work, and it carried over into his professional life as well. His work ethic was strong, and he gained the respect of fellow workers and customers alike. In the 1970s, Steve outfitted a Ford van with living accommodations, filled the tank with gas, and took off to see America. He spent nearly a year on the road, crisscrossing America, the adventure of a lifetime. He saw places that most people just read about. When he returned home, he settled down to a more domestic life, but he always had the look in his eye, and he wanted to be someplace else. That is how he came to be in Oregon. He was able to continue his wandering with a purpose, traveling to meet his customers. He never missed a chance to stop and see an old friend or a family member along the way. Steve was extremely easygoing. He loved meeting people, a gift that served him well as a salesman and a teacher. I don't know if some of you knew that he was a teacher at Mount Hood Community College, along with everything else he did. He could strike up a conversation with anyone, and after an hour, you could ask him how he knew that person, and he'd say, "I didn't know him, but I do now." His friends were friends for life. Thanks to all who reached out to him when he was ill. He appreciated every phone call and every note. Special thanks to Martha Hansen and all those friends who helped him. Thank you, Steve, for all the laughter, smiles, tears, and good times we had together. This is the gift of memories we all will always share. So that's the one from Fred and Margaret. But there's another one from a mere friend of 33 years. His friend was and still is a very famous photographer, and we have those pictures of Steve to thank for it. Steve met him when he was courting Katsy, and he was a teacher at East Gresham Grade School. So this is his remembrance of Steve. It's been about a month now since we lost Steve, and it's high time I contacted all of you with some special words and images. First, a bit about me and Steve. Steve married a colleague of mine, Katsy, in 1990. Being a male teacher in a female-dominated profession, elementary ed, it was always good to make friends with one or more of your husbands, the husbands of your colleagues. For me and Steve, it was friendship at first sight. We developed a lot of common ground over the years, but the three aspects that stand out are mushrooms, grasses, and poker. Soon after getting to know him during Katsy and Steve's courtship, 1998 to 1990, I got Steve involved in my once a month poker group. Low stakes, but loads of fun. You can win big or lose big in one sitting, sometimes for months in a row, up or down. But over the years, the money tends to be passed around the table. For the past 2 or 3 years, Steve's illnesses made his attendance intermittent. And now the COVID since March. Our long-standing once-a-month game has been postponed until after the duration. But there will always be an empty chair for him when we get restarted. As you all know, Steve was a noted authority in the field of ornamental grasses. I had no idea what he was talking about when he and Katsy first told me about it. But after a while, and upon seeing his own home garden and many landscapes that he'd engineered, I became a convert. I also shot many images for him to use in his marketing, mainly of mature varieties of ornamental grass already established in landscapes. I truly enjoyed doing these, as I could shoot ornamental grass photos after school. And being plants, I could take my time in composing images of them. I didn't have to ask them to smile. In his knowledge of wild mushrooms, if his wild knowledge of wild mushrooms isn't legendary, it should be. Truffles as well. He knew where all the best hunting areas were near Estacada, and I was privileged to go with him on many of his hunts. I got to go on two of them. Those two together were hysterically funny. He taught me how to look for them, how to harvest and clean them, and how to prepare them for immediate consumption and for storage. Two of the attached images are from such hunts. There's Steve with his chanterelles, and Steve with his dependable pickup truck and Sparky. I miss him every day and wish we could continue our friendship into our oncoming old age. They both turned 70 this year. But there are things you can't control or change. I hope all of you have found such fast friends in your circle and that you've accumulated an equally rich treasure trove of memories.
Stand. We come to this part of the service in which we do a prayer that's actually sung and incensed. There's the psalmist who said, "Let my prayers arise like incense before you." So we will incense this here, and it's a way of praying also for him. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Thank you.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Steve, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Steve again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the kingdom of joy. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.